Hello, everybody who's watching.
Yes, hello.
Hello.
Hi, we're so happy you are all here today. Okay, as we get to moving forward right now, I'd like to introduce you to our team today. My name is Donna. I'm from the Washington State. Been an optician there for a number of years. So I'm not going to tell you how many because that'll tell you how old I am. So we want to make sure we keep that short and sweet. I'd like to introduce you to Lisa. She is from Massachusetts. Lisa, say something.
Hi, everyone. I'm the Secretary of the State Society of Massachusetts. I've been in the business now for about 8 years and I love leadership.
The next panel is going to be Tina. And she's from Michigan.
I am from Michigan. It is freezing here. And I'm the director of the Opticians Association of Michigan. I've been on the board for 3 years. And I have been in the field for about going on 6 years. And every day is something new. And I love it. I think that's like the best part.
And hi, finally, we have John.
I can't wait. Hi, I'm John. I'm a husband, a dad, an optician, and president of the Opticians Association of Ohio. And it's just as cold in Ohio. We're glad everybody's here with us today.
Fantastic. Thank you, everybody. We would like all of you right now in the chat, would you put your name so we know who you are and put what state you represent? The chat is the button at the very bottom. By now, you probably are very familiar with that, as is all the classes you've been attending.
Oh, all over. I love it.
Oh, it's exciting. I love it. My own state is here. Yay! Okay. Robert, great having you with us, Robert. Super Michigan's here. Woohoo! Good for you, Tina.
Hi, Miss Queen.
My old buddy from Oregon, Robert's here today too. And my friend from South Carolina, Ronnie. Hello.
A lot of old friends here.
Good to have you. I tell you, it is just wonderful. It's been a long time, Skip Rivard. I haven't seen you since last time we were on a mission together. Good to have you join us. Okay, while we're finishing up there, can we get we have two polling questions we would like you to answer for us right now before we get started. So if we can get the first polling question, would be awesome. Thank you so much. Okay, on a polling, everybody jump in and answer the question. Hey, David, is it working or not working? Because nobody is evidently seeing it.
All questions are working. We have about 80% answer the questions. Do you want
me to? Okay. We're just not seeing it on our end. Okay. Thank you very much. Let's go to the second polling question then.
You want to see the
results?
Welcome,
Hannah.
We have the first one.
You should see the result now.
There we go. Thank you.
Oh, there we go. Yeah. Awesome. Awesome. Okay, team, check that out, would you? We have 90% that are ABO. That just warms my heart right here, right at the very soul. Okay, can we get that second polling question going?
The reason for these polls is so we can get a better idea of who our audience is and where we're all coming from.
Thank you. As soon as the polling is done, and if you guys would show it to us, then we will know that you finished with it. Thank you very much. So good to have everybody today. I hope it's warm in your state.
Should D be, has no association?
Yes, it should.
Yeah, for those of you answering, that was instead of has an association, it should be has no association.
It's supposed to be actually,
Perfect. 80% of the people here on the board. That's really great. That shows a lot about your state society. Okay, we're going to get started with a video now because we want to get you all inspired and all excited. So let's let it roll.
A lollipop moment, a moment where someone said something or did something that you feel fundamentally made your life better. All right. How many of you have told that person they did it? See, why not? We celebrate birthdays where all you have to do is not die for 365 days. And yet we let people who have made our lives better walk around without knowing it. And every single one of you, every single one of you has been the catalyst for a lollipop moment. You have made someone's life better by something that you said or that you did. And if you think you haven't, think about all the hands that didn't go back up when I asked that question. You're just one of the people who hasn't been told. But it is so scary to think of ourselves as that powerful. It can be frightening to think that we can matter that much to other people. Because as long as we make leadership something bigger than us, as long as we keep leadership something beyond us, as long as we make it about changing the world, we give ourselves an excuse not to expect it every day from ourselves and from each other. Marianne Williamson said, "Our greatest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our greatest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light and not our darkness that frightens us." And my call to action today is that we need to get over that. We need to get over our fear of how extraordinarily powerful we can be in each other's lives. We need to get over it so we can move beyond it. And our little brothers and our little sisters, and one day our kids, or our kids right now, can watch us start to value the impact we can have on each other's lives more than money and power and titles and influence. We need to redefine leadership as being about lollipop moments. How many of them we create, how many of them we acknowledge, how many of them we pay forward, and how many of them we say thank you for. Because we've made leadership about changing the world, and there is no world. There's only 6 billion understandings of it. And if you change one person's understanding of it, one person's understanding of what they're capable of, one person's understanding of how much people care about them, one person's understanding of how powerful an agent for change they can be in this world, you've changed the whole thing. And if we can understand leadership like that, I think if we can redefine leadership like that, I think we can change everything. And it's a simple idea. But I don't think it's a small one. And I want to thank you all so much for letting me share it with you today.
Okay, we want to hear what your lollipop moment is to get you on a committee. So if we can have our next polling question, if there was any committee that you could be on, what would it be? So if we can have the next polling question, we'll get moving. Lisa, can you tell me what your lollipop moment is? Oh, look at that. Educational conferences. Woohoo! Love it, love it, love it. I wouldn't be on the newsletter either because I have trouble just, you know, talking out loud. But Lisa, tell us your lollipop moment.
Sure. I probably have a lot in my life, but the one I was thinking about the most, that fundamentally changed my life and put me into the career that I'm in now is I have always been a really hard worker and I will stick through anything to the end. And I was really unhappy in my job. I have a psych degree and I had found myself somehow working with daycare kids and I was really miserable. And, you know, I had a conversation with George and he gave me the permission to quit my job. And I feel like he really inspired me to find something else in life that would bring me happiness. And that led me to Optical. So I would say that, you know, that him allowing me to quit was my lollipop moment that brought me into opticianry.
Awesome. Tina, what is yours?
So mine is when my boss, which is the doctor, the optometrist, he actually told me that I inspired him and kept him on his toes, which means I have to keep kept on my toes because I want to make sure that I'm always asking questions like I normally do. But that was kind of just the start of it because I want to keep learning. And then when he is over here saying, I inspire him to keep doing his job, it's not something that you would take lightly. So that's kind of where it's nice to hear that you inspire someone and then going forward with it.
Absolutely. Inspiration for all of us to encourage people to be all they can be. That's what mm-hmm. our jobs are, I think. John, what is your lollipop moment?
I have lollipops every day, it feels like, but one of my most recent was during COVID. We had shut down all our offices and we had one office open and we had the lab was just working to get all the rest of the jobs out. And after about 5 days, everything was set. And there was one guy left and I went in and I told him, I said, you know, we were still getting paid. Everybody's going to get paid to go home. But I said, you know, you're welcome to go home as soon as you finish up these jobs. And he kind of looked at me kind of funny. And I went back in, you know, the office and I saw him walking by really slow. And I said, hey, is everything okay? And he said, do you mind if I stay? And I'm like, yeah, but you'll get paid to go home. He's like, yeah, but I really like being here. He said, I want to be here with the other people who are calling me. And it made me realize that this is more than just a job. To me, it's always more than just a job. But to the staff, too, and the people around you, we impact them on so many different levels that we never, ever realize. And it just, that was probably one of the biggest, benefits of COVID, in fact, too, is that it really, really opened up a lot of eyes as to the relationships we have with the people at work.
Fantastic. Okay, everybody, I would like everybody in like 10 seconds to type in really quickly what one lollipop moment is for you. As we do that, it really is funny. We all have lollipop moments that inspire us. My great lollipop moment was meeting Diane Charles. Many of you know Diane. And I always told her, I said, I really, when I grow up, I want to be just like you in the optical field. And we have developed the strongest, lastingest relationship from that and still inspire each other. And that's what we all need to do, is be an inspiration to that. Okay, can we get our next polling question, please?
Some people are commenting in the chat too.
Yeah, I see that. They can comment all day long.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, you guys can just take time to do your poll and then we can go back to, you can go back to typing at your convenience.
Hannah Cannon, she had said being approached by the board to join. That's awesome. I can relate to that. I'll actually be talking about that momentarily.
And how important is that all we have to do is ask?
Yeah. Oh, you know, exactly. Exactly.
How many people do we not ask?
Yeah.
They go by us.
You know, so true. Many people sit in the back of the room and they never know. Look at everybody. Both. I love that. 75% is great. Love it. Yeah. Many of us, a lot of times, will sit back in the room, and if we are not initiators to get them initiated, to get them involved into joining a board, and we don't ever accomplish what we hope to do. If you wait for people to come to the front and say, hey, I'll do it, they won't do it. But if you just happen to notice them and develop conversations, will work great. Okay, Tina, or actually I missed the page. I wanna know Lisa. Oh, Lisa, what is your lollipop moment at work every day?
I love working with patients. I feel like when you can find a pair of eyewear that's functional but also fashionable and the patient is really excited about it, you know, that just inspires me to want to keep coming to work every day and helping the patients.
Okay, excellent. Tina, what lollipop moment motivates you in your state society?
Actually, when I was on it was not during a meeting, it was just a random talk to one of the board members. they had said that they wanted new blood on the board. And that kind of just took a moment, was thinking, it's not good to keep doing the same thing. If you have new things, new blood in on the board, then you have different results and new ideas. You know, if you do the same thing all the time, you're gonna get the same result. And I can, that's from the famous Ron Witt. I got that from him, so thank you. But it was just one of those times where it's true. If you do the same thing, you get the same result. But if you have new ideas, then different things happen. And that's what we wanna see.
Absolutely. Can we get another polling question, please?
We're making them work today.
I tell you, isn't that the truth? Well, they're getting that polling question up. John, what do you, well, let's wait. We've got our polling question. Oh, Caesar, I think that is so special. 6-year-old son telling me he wants to be an optician like daddy. I love
that's
it.
That's the best. That is the best.
My granddaughter grew up to be an optician, and my other granddaughter grew up to be a technician down in Oregon. So she's a certified ophthalmic technician. So that is exciting. Being a mentor. I love being mentors. Okay, and with, great. All of the above.
From Ben Lowry, he said that when the doctor trusted the script that I got for troubleshooting, I feel like that was what I would say, because I actually had that happen a couple days ago. So I hear you. It was kind of like, oh, I'm that smart. I can do this. So it was a nice moment where they put trust in you. So I can relate to that.
Absolutely. I like that. And I do like Dorothy's response to going to help the optical. Isn't that great? What a great lollipop moment for her too. John, what do you do to inspire your staff to get the best performance out of them?
I try to have some empathy, and instead of, you know, trying to see things from my perspective, I try to put myself in their shoes. I had a exit interview with somebody who was leaving the company, this young girl, about 19 years old. And I asked why she's leaving, and she looked me right in the eye and she said, you know, this is your dream, not mine. And I'm like, whoa. And I said, coming from somebody that young, it really hit me between the eyes. But I started thinking about that every day. You know, I'm coming to work with my dream, but what are the, you know, the dreams of the people I'm working with? And how can I turn, you know, what I want them to do for us into part of their dream? So that's why I try to inspire them.
Okay, great. One more polling question, everybody. We want you guys to be as involved in this as we are. This isn't about us. It's all about you. Hannah, I like your comment. That was very, very nice. Helping those who work with to succeed. I'm an optical manager as of October, and it's wonderful to be part of an advancing knowledge and success of the office. That is really, really self, makes you feel good about yourself and about what you can do. All right, all of the above, everybody agrees on that one. That's great. Lisa, what inspired you today to come to leadership?
I have been coming to leadership now since I was an apprentice. And so I am always inspired by the peers that I meet and the networking and the things that I learn and can bring back, not just to my state society, but also to my profession and in at work. Like sometimes I learn things from people that make our office a better place.
Awesome. it always has inspired me to go to leadership because I wanted to take back to the state society what I learned and to help our state society be a better, strong state society. And that's what leadership does for your state. It helps you become a stronger state society. If you don't have a state society, it encourages you to get one going and get started. Don't you guys agree?
Yeah.
Sure.
All right, let's go to another polling question. Thank you, Lisa. Hey, we only got 15 minutes. We're going to have to hurry. Where did our time go, you guys?
We're just having too much fun.
Yeah, we are. We're going to probably jump ahead just a little bit so that we can get ahead of this. I would like you right now, if you wouldn't mind, to put the next video on for them because this is very important to leadership.
I can guarantee it will be the biggest financial mistake of your life. My name is Louis Navalier, and I'm a member of America's 1%. I manage over $1 billion for America.
I have a lot of memories from when I was a child. One that's always stuck out to me, though, was when I was about 10 years old, and I was in school, and I struggled. And I didn't struggle with English, math, or science. I struggled holding still. And I would try to listen and focus and process ideas, but I couldn't help myself. And to be honest, I would sit there and then I would just start tapping. And the students in the class would look at me and they'd say, "Hey, stop tapping." A lot of the time, I didn't even realize I was doing it. And then eventually even the teachers got after me and they would yell at me and they'd say, "Clint, you have to stop tapping." It got so bad that I got sent to the principal's office for tapping. And he said to me, "Okay, maybe when you go back to class, just try sitting on your hands." And so I did. I went back to class, and when I felt myself starting to tap, I did this. I sat on my hands. And that worked for about 5 seconds. One time I was tapping in class, and my teacher, Mr. Jensen, he looked at me and he yelled. And he said, "Clint, stay after class." And I thought to myself, this is it. I am done. Now, I've always been the type of person that believes that a single moment in time can change a person's life. And this was one of those moments for me, and I will never forget it. And so I was sitting there with Mr. Jensen and an empty classroom. And he walked past me and he sat next to his desk and he said, "Clint, come here, I want to talk to you." And as he looked me right in the eye, he said, "Now, I need you to know something, you're not in trouble. But I do have just one question that I have to ask you." And he asked, he said, "Have you ever thought about playing the drums?" And in that moment, Mr. Jensen, he leaned back and he opened the top drawer of his desk. And he reached in and he pulled out my very first pair of drumsticks. And he held them in his hands and he looked at me and he said, "Hey, Clint, you're not a problem. I think you're a drummer." Moment on, I've never put those sticks down. I've toured, recorded, and played drums all over the world. My whole college education was paid for with drumsticks in my hand. Just because of a single moment in time when somebody believed in me and he saw something in me that I didn't even see within myself. And from that moment, I learned that there's a difference between being the best in the world and being the best for the world.
Everybody has a mentor in their life and who inspired them. I've already shared my mentor with you. And for the sake of trying to get us through everything that we want to cover today, I'm going to just kind of forge ahead a little bit, panel. So you'll have to just grin and bear it. Lisa, in the beginning of your optical career, who and what helped guide you to inspire you to be an optician?
Well, I'm really lucky because my husband's been an optician for over 20 years. So in the beginning, I had him, and Debbie Bartlett was really inspired me to become an apprentice. And at the same time, my best friend was working for us and she had started apprenticing. So it was really inspiring to actually take, we went on the journey together. So, you know, we had two really great mentors and then we had each other. So I feel like I got to start off really strong and inspired.
I love that. Tina, do you have a mentor to energize you and to keep you going on your, in your position at, with your state society?
I do. I have two. And one is, of course, my boss. He's been with me since day one. He's always pushed me to keep going. He's always told me any kind of certification, he goes, go for the ABO, go for the NCLE. And then there's never a dull moment. There's never something where he stops trying to push me. And it's great. He always says, well, I want you on the board. I want you, you know, to be on the OAM. I want you to do this. And it's never ending, I guess you could say. And then my other one is the president of the OAM is Sue Shire. She is always, always, always on me about everything, which is great. She's always saying, okay, what's going on with this? What's going on with this? And I love it. I love being pushed to do something, but I love it when they have your back and they can help you and guide you and they can support you. It's nice to have that. And sometimes when you have that, someone else is looking in and going, oh, well, she can do that. Then they can come to me and they can ask me a question and I can potentially inspire someone else to do something. So it just kind of goes down the line with that. So I'm lucky to have two.
Okay. Patricia asked a direct question to me is what inspired, I was the leadership chair for 2 years. What inspired me to do it? My inspiration comes from so many people, but I wanted to be able to present the best that we could for leadership and help it grow in ways that it hadn't been before. I was at the very first leadership meeting that we ever did and met a lot of people that inspired me to keep going and helping and keeping state societies up. And I have a passion for it. I have a passion for the optical industry. That has always been my inspiration anyway. So it was just giving back what I had gotten for myself. And that's what my inspiration is. And that's what the inspiration is that keeps moving me forward in this beautiful, beautiful profession that we're all part of. And I had a lot of mentors. Diane Charles probably was my first mentor. Shirley Early has been a great mentor to me. I've had some of the best mentors in the world. Robert Russo. I can just go on naming many of them that helped me to grow in this. And this is what leadership does for you. It keeps you motivated and it keeps you going. Okay, John, and if you don't know it, John is also the president of the Ohio Board of Directors. What inspires you to rise up and be part of the Association of Ohio?
There was one moment where I love live education. I just can't get enough of it. And I was sitting in one of the seminars and it was really, really powerful, whatever they were saying. It was on marketing and I was looking around the room and I was thinking, actually, I'm really glad that I'm here, but I also wish more of my employees were here. And I kind of bummed me out that a lot of my competition was there. So I said, they're getting all this. And I said, I need to get more involved and get my staff and get other people, you know, around the state involved. And also, you know, if you're from a licensed state, you're always under pressure for your license. You're always trying to connect it. You're always trying to not connect it. You're always trying to protect it. And so just the thought of me having been able to build a career out of a two-year degree and out of a license that has, you know, you can get with a two-year apprenticeship, and that there's other people that might lose that if I didn't go up and help fight for that. And I knew there's other people fighting behind the scenes. And one of those people was Shirley Early, who was a big inspiration to me. And so going to the meetings, I became got to know her better, and she inspired me to go into the to become more active on the board. And that was how I got to be here.
Awesome. Okay, I want all of our attendees at this time, I want to know, do you have a mentor that energizes you to be all that you can be in your job or on your board of directors, state society member, or whatever you participate in? Want you right now to write it in the chat who your mentor is and what inspires you. We're gonna do a little bit of chatting with this for a minute, guys. I was just informed we have 15 strong minutes left, so we wanna make sure that we have good opportunity to discuss it.
We know it's you, Lisa. You lit up.
Life happens.
Hey,
right?
That's what makes everything good, is because it's real. This is real life, guys.
That was the only way we had to prove it wasn't recorded.
Right.
Thank you, Lee.
Sorry, guys.
No, you're fine. That's funny.
This is the first time she's barked all day, though, so that's pretty good.
Debbie Bartlett is an inspiration to all of us. Eric Williams is a sweetheart. You guys all are coming up with some really great, great, great ones. I love every minute of it. Ed DeGennaro, oh, he's a sweet one. He always inspires everybody.
Oh, there's one for you, John, from Patricia in there.
I didn't see it.
It's scroll up a little bit. I can read it if you want.
Jonna Dukes.
I'm sure you're gonna find it.
Thank you, Jonna. You are my inspiration, my breath. Love you, girl.
Can you see
and
it?
Thank you, Heidi. Yeah.
If I can answer Patricia's question, it just says, Ohio has always had a huge presence of leadership. How did you go from one store to multiple locations, and how do you stay inspired? I'm inspired by my staff. I've got the most awesome staff, and they seem to attract more better staff. And I've got a lot of young people who aren't afraid to ask my older staff for help. And it's just, I just continue to be inspired by my staff. They do an awesome job, and we're kind of like an army. We feel like there's nothing we can't do. If there's a place we want to open an office, we're like, let's charge, let's do this. So yeah, it had to be my staff.
Yeah, I would have to say one of my inspirations is the Washington's board of directors. They, when I decided that I was going to step down from the position of executive director, it really inspired me how each one of them, some of them don't know that they've been groomed for quite a long time to take over those positions, because I always knew that sometime I would probably retire. Mayan is one of them that I inspired from the time she got out of school to get her up to where she could take over. She's second VP right now. Heidi Adams has been going to leadership for quite some time, and to bring her up into a position where, yes, she can take over. And my whole board of directors has just jumped up and has taken the whole ball and decided to go with it. So that really has inspired me after 20 years of being the executive director that, hey, it's going to go whether I'm there or not, and that people that have been groomed all these years without them knowing it, sometimes you have to give people a little nudge without them knowing it and keep them motivated and going. So, being an inspiration to people is something I enjoy to do. Some of us are more gifted with it than others, and some of us have that ability. But you know what? I want every optician in the United States to be a success. So if it takes me to my very last breath, I will never retire, and I will still continue to do that. So let's talk a little bit about leadership. You guys are all here at leadership right now, and leadership means so much to so many of us. Leadership, it takes everyone working together as a team. There is no such thing as I in team. We're all a team, we all work together. So it's not any one person that makes this whole ball game work. So can we have the video on leadership, please, the next video. Is it possible to get that in full screen? If we all had the wisdom of geese, we would know that we all need each other. It takes every single one of us to make everything work. Every organization, everything you do in your life, be like the goose. Lisa, as a board member, what are your strengths and how can you share them with your board?
I find one of my strengths to be that I have good communication skills and I pay attention to the little things. And this can be good or bad, but I also have the ability to see things from all sides. So even if I have a strong opinion about something, I can always see someone else's opinion on the thing. And the way that I bring it to the board is I always speak up. I encourage other members by seeing their strengths and kind of, you know, if I see someone that I think would be really good on our events committee, sometimes people are afraid to stand up. So I may invite them to the table. So I find that, you know, just not being shy and being able to speak out really can help encourage other people by giving them the courage and the strength that I have myself.
Excellent. Excellent. And that's what it takes. Be free to ask people and recognize everybody's strengths and their weaknesses. Tina, what are your weaknesses?
My weaknesses would be not asking enough questions. It's more so with both being on the board and at work. I will notice that if I don't know something, I don't want to ask. So I want to just find out myself. But then I tell myself, well, that's how you learn too. If you ask, then that's how you learn. So if I ask more questions about it, if you are also, it doesn't matter if they've been in the field for however long they have, if you don't use it, you lose it. That's my other motto too. So if you don't always use that formula or always do that task and you forget how to do it, that's possible. You can just ask again, but I need to do that. What needs to happen?
Okay, John, as the president, how would you energize your board if they weren't getting the results of the mission statement? I switched that up on you a little bit.
That's okay. How would I energize them if they weren't getting it? Well, it all depend if why. I'd find out the reason why they weren't getting it. It was something in the way I was communicating it. I would try to make it a little bit more clear. And again, you know, try to see what their what their vantage point is, where they're seeing it from, and just try to what I try to do is always look at the end point and try to get people to go there. It's hard to lead somebody if they don't know where you're trying to lead them to. So I try to make everything as goal oriented as we can, and show them, you know, what the fruits of the journey will be.
Okay, Lisa, to share your strengths, how would you encourage your board members with your strengths?
Like I said before, I would probably help by pulling out of them what I see as their potential. And so that I feel like, you know, and also leading by example. I think that if you do the things that you want other people to do in a way, or hold yourself in that way, then people, they start to all do the same thing. So it's kind of like, you know, if you have a lot of excitement, people around you will have a lot of excitement.
Ben had wrote something in the comment that really makes sense. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make them drink. That is
absolutely,
that is so, yes, 100% true. I mean, you can have someone work, and if you don't see the passion behind it, then you can't force someone to do it.
The horse has to be thirsty.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Absolutely. Exactly.
You need to make them want to drink. That is very, very true. Tina, as executive director, do you ask for help and how from your board, and how does your board give you the tools you need to succeed? That is probably key. If we don't give people the tools and give them the direction sometime, they do not know what to do. So yeah. How do you do it?
I just, honestly, as simple as writing an email. It doesn't take much. You just ask everyone, ask what their opinion is, and sometimes they can give you some things, give you some feedback that is a little bit better, or they just approve. It all depends, but it's a team. It's not my board, it's our board. It's the OAM. So if you're not, mm-hmm. If you don't ask, I mean, then what kind of board is that? But we all work together. We all have differences. We all have different opinions, and that is what makes us a board and what makes us stick together. Different things, and one time it can change everything. One sentence can change someone else's point of view with it.
Absolutely. The key is not to be afraid to ask, but then the other part of that is don't be afraid to listen.
Correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And so many people, when they get into these positions, they get to thinking, they get threatened or whatever. Just remember, there it takes all of us to make the team. And without you, there isn't a team. Right. So if one person is missing, then it does make a whole lot of differences. We have three groups in every job and state association. We have leaders, we have worker bees, and we also have bench setters. How does the leader encourage the workers bees to stay energized? And you can put it in the comments right now. We're down to 2 minutes, so you can just kind of throw a question in there and we'll kind of follow along and jump in and help. How do you encourage worker bees to stay energized? And while they're doing that, John, how do you keep people energized?
How do I keep them energized? Depending on what the situation is. With the board, you've got to have an energized group of people to start with. I mean, a battery that's dead can't be recharged. So you need to have people that really want to be there. I think the most important thing is finding out what their strengths are and letting them shine in what they're best at. And, you know, if you're putting them in the wrong roles or forcing roles upon them, it's not going to work. And you have to remember, these are all, you know, we're all volunteers. You know, mm-hmm. so we need to make sure that they're getting a lot out of this, not just for the board, but for themselves too, for personal growth. And they're challenged, and they're really benefiting from everything we're doing for them.
Or appreciate
we're getting some really good. We're getting some really good feedback. We have to sell the experience and not sell the product. Share positive stories, encouragement, praise for a job well done. I really believe in that one with all my heart. Show your excitement along with them to the goals, but from a board standpoint, and I've been on a board for 20 years now, is you have to have a vision. And if you don't have a vision and you don't provide the tools, then that's where your first lack of failure as a board of directors. To energize them, keep giving new visions. You can't take a 20-year-old vision and expect it to be what it should be today. Everyone has different visions, and don't be afraid to listen to new ideas. So that's what keeps a board alive. That's what makes everything look good. Okay, we have really done, our time went way too fast. David, I'm going to let you take it over right now. I would like to thank my board or my panel. We've had a wonderful time putting this together for you. Lisa, yes, Tina, John, you guys are my heroes.
Okay. Thank all you attendees too.
Thank you for all your time and hanging out with us today.